Hello everyone and welcome to another After Effects tutorial. My name is Tyler Bradway and this is Creativid Studios. Today I'm going to be showing you how to move a texture along a path so that it bends and warps to maneuver its way through that path, kind of like a snake. So that's what we're going to be using as our texture, the scaled snake. And normally you can do this with a shape layer, but you can't add a texture to it that moves along with it. First thing you're gonna wanna do is have a texture and a shape. So this is, the texture was just some scales and I made the shape the snake with little cute little eyes. You're gonna wanna make sure it is 1920 by 1080 or whatever size your final animation composition is gonna be, or else this won't work, because it's using the position of the layer relative to the composition of the final animation to determine where the nulls and pins should be. So yeah, so we're gonna be using the puppet pin tool to do this and making nulls that follow the path and using the pins to warp the mesh of the snake to follow the path. Okay, so let's jump right into it. So here's the texture. I'm just gonna make another composition using this texture so that it's the same size. Command K, I'm gonna rename it moving. First, let's make the path it's gonna follow. So we'll do a new shape layer with the pen tool. We'll just draw in a path. Okay, so here's the path. It's just a janky little path. Doesn't really matter for the purposes of the tutorial. You're gonna wanna make sure the path is exactly how you need it to be. Select the shape layer, hit U twice on your keyboard. Select path and hit Command C or Control C on a Windows. And layer new null object. With this null object, we're gonna actually label it. We'll call it motion 1. Okay, so this is gonna be the first null, essentially the head of the snake, I think. It might end up being the tail of the snake if we reverse the order of what we're doing by accident. Let's hit position and select the path, hit Command C, which we already did actually, and then Command V to paste the path onto the position of the motion null. We also need all of these keyframes to be just a keyframe for every frame so that we can offset the timing correctly. So we'll do that by alt-clicking the position, then just clicking off of the position, and then keyframe assistant, convert expression to keyframes. So now that made a keyframe for every frame. Just gonna delete the second half of this. Let's zoom in a little. Now we gotta make the other nulls. Let's make 5 nulls and 5 pins. So we're gonna attach each pin, puppet pin tool, this pin tool. It's used to deform objects in After Effects. If you link the puppet pin to the position of a null, it'll follow that null. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna position, have a bunch of nulls following this path, and each one corresponds to another null, and then it deforms the snake along the path. So we gotta figure out how to get the timing of the nulls to be offset in space and time, actually. So to do that, we're gonna duplicate this null, this null to make motion 2, and then duplicate it 3 more times to make 5, and then select them all and hit U to open. It's gonna open the position because that's the only one that has keyframes on it. Okay, so motion 5 is the tail, so it's gonna be offset the most. So we're gonna go to the 4th frame on the motion 2, delete it, and delete all the other frames there in the beginning. And do the same for the top 3, Now, for this one, we're going to do the same thing. This one, the same thing. And just these. Next, we'll delete the last four on the second, on motion four. Last four on all the other ones, actually. And that, and that, and that. Well, they kind of just, like, collect together. So this one will hop onto the other nulls, and it will just, like, they'll just follow the same path, and then they'll separate out again. We don't want that. So we'll move all the keyframes to line up with the beginning of the animation. So there's the in and the out are at the same spot. So now they're offset in space, and they're gonna end at the same time. Now we'll hide the shape layer. So we'll select the texture and make five puppet pins. One at the head, the first one at the head, second one like between, like a quarter of the way across the body, third one in the middle, fourth one three quarters of the way, and then the fifth one at the tail. So now we hit U on our keyboard to open the position of the puppet pins, and we can delete these keyframes and just under hold Alt and click puppet one and pull it up to motion one. And yeah, we did it backwards. If you followed mine step by step, you're gonna have it opposite. That's fine, we can just go in the opposite order when we link them. So we do Alt, click the position next to five, put it to one. Four goes with two. Three goes with three. Two goes with four. And one goes with five. Okay, let's take a look at what we got. Wow, that's so janky. So the more puppet pins and nulls you have, the less janky it's gonna look. I just kept it a low number so that this tutorial didn't last forever. Yeah, that's it for this tutorial, guys. I hope you learned something. You didn't need a plug-in to do this. Don't forget to like this video, and I'll see you later.